Good morning, children. So, hope you all have studied that how to balance a chemical equation. Okay. So, those who didn't understand, go through the previous videos and all. Okay. So, today we are going to continue the remaining portions in our first chapter, Language of Chemistry. So, the next topic that we are going to study is information conveyed by a balanced chemical equations. What are the informations that an chemical equation will carry? So, for that, I am showing you one example. Okay. See, here I am writing one reaction, that is H2 plus O2, okay, gives. So two substances I have mentioned here, hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. So when these two gases are reacting together, without writing the product name, you can imagine what will be the product going to form, right? So what all are the informations that an balanced equation will carry? So on looking on the equation itself, you can say the product, what will be the result of a chemical reaction. On looking into this equation itself, you can say what will be the result of this reaction. What will be the result here when H2 combines with O2? What will be the result? The result formed will be H2O, water molecule, water vapor will be formed, right? So on looking in the equation, you can say the actual result of a chemical change, right? So first information that an equation will carry is the actual result. So instead of H2 and O2, I am writing on another equation, that is H2 plus Cl2, hydrogen and chlorine will combine together. What will be the product forming? On looking on the reactant itself, we can say the product, what will be the product forming? You can say that will be, which is the product forming here? The product forming will be HCl. HCl will be formed here. Okay. Then, next, what is the next information? So, the first information it will carry is the actual result. We can identify the actual result formed. And then next information that a chemical equation will be carrying. What is the next information? What about the reactant involved and the reactant involved and the product formed as the result of the same first point itself? What will be the react, what will be the products and what will be the reactants involved? So in this equation, so one equation I have written here, H2 plus Cl2 gives 2 HCl. okay, from this equation you can say which all are the reactants. Which all are the reactants? Hydrogen gas and chlorine gas combine together to form HCl molecule, hydrogen chloride molecule. So on looking into the chemical equation, you can say what all are the reactants and what all are the product formed, right? So this is the second point. First point is, on looking in the reaction, we can say what will be the result or what will be the product formed directly. Okay, we can say that. Second point is, on looking at a complete reaction, we can say which all are the reactants formed and which all are the product formed. If we know the symbols of the, or if you know the formula of the compounds. Okay. Then what is the third point? How many about, see, it is there in your textbook, page number 13. Okay. Point C, about the number of molecules of each substance taking part and formed in the reaction. So in this equation, how many number of molecules or how many number of atoms are present in the equation? You can say, no, see here, H2, that means H2 means a hydrogen molecule. How many hydrogen molecules are there? How many hydrogen molecules are there? 1 H2, that means only one hydrogen molecule, and 1 Cl2, one chlorine molecule. So 2 HCl, that means 2 HCl molecule. So on looking into the equation, you can say how many number of molecules have taken part in this reaction. So first information is what will be the result of the reaction. That is the first information. Second information is what will be the reactants and what will be the products, that we can say from looking in the equation. Then the third information that an equation will convey is how many number of molecules, how many number of hydrogen molecules, how many number of chlorine molecules and how many number of HCl molecules are formed. We can say on looking in the reaction. Okay. Then So next one is about the chemical composition of the respective molecule. And see here, one molecule of, so how you can say the chemical composition from this equation? One molecule of hydrogen combined with one molecule of chlorine to form two molecules of HCl. So this is the chemical composition. So on looking in this chemical equation itself, you can say their chemical composition. So what is the chemical composition here? For the formation of two molecules of HCl, for the formation of two molecules of HCl, it require one molecule of hydrogen and one molecule of chlorine. So from looking in the equation itself, we can say their chemical composition also. Okay, the next information conveyed is the total mass of the substance. The total, if you know the mass of the hydrogen plus mass of the chlorine gives the total mass of HCl. This topic we will study in the coming session. That time you will understand it in detail. Okay, now just you have to remember it. What is an inf- so if it will ask, last year board exam it was there, write any five informations that a chemical equation conveys. Okay, write any five informations that a balanced equation conveys. Last year's board exam question it was. So what all are the informations? First information is it will show the actual result of a chemical change. What will be the result or what will be the product formed? First information. Second information is what are the reactants and what will be the products that we can identify on looking into a chemical equation. Third one is how many number of molecules have taken part in a reaction. Okay, the number of molecules present in a during a chemical reaction we can identify on looking in the equation. Then next one is how many, what is the chemical composition, like one molecule of hydrogen combined with one molecule of chlorine to form two molecule of HCl. That is the chemical composition. And next, the total mass of the substance. We can identify the total mass of the substance from a chemical equation. This much only, don't want to explain it, okay? Then next, the chemical equation, a balanced equation will show the law of conservation of mass. In 8th standard, you have studied what is law of conservation of mass. What is that? Matter can neither be created nor be destroyed, but the total mass of the substance remains same before and after a chemical reaction. You have studied, no? So, if it is a balanced equation, you can say the total mass of the hydrogen will be equal to the total mass of hydrogen in the product side, and the total mass of chlorine will be equal to the total mass of chlorine in the product side. This is law of conservation of mass. See here, there are two H2s are there. When it is balanced, two hydrogen is present. There is two chlorine are there. Right side also two chlorine. So the total mass, this shows a balanced equation will obey the law of conservation of mass. So this much are the information. So many other informations are also there. You have to study at least this much law of this much informations. Okay. Then next we are going to study. What all are the limitations of a chemical equations? What all are the limitations of a chemical equations? Limitations. Okay. What all are the limitations? Very important topic. Okay. So what all are the informations that a chemical equation does not carry? Disadvantages of a chemical equation. Okay. So one equation I am writing here. Okay. Which equation I will write? One equation, one more equation I am writing, same type. Okay, so these are the equations I have written. So what are the disadvantages that this equation have? Okay, that means, see, on looking in this first equation, C plus O2 gives CO2. On looking this equation, can you say at what time this reaction will complete? Or how many time it needed to complete this reaction, the time required, will it show here? No. Or what is the state of substance, whether it is solid, liquid or gas? This carbon, is it solid state or liquid state or gaseous state? Is it mentioned here? The state of substance, is it mentioned in an equation? No. Then whether it is an exothermic reaction or endothermic reaction, is it mentioned here? No. Or is it complete or incomplete? So nothing, many of the informations are not given in a chemical equation. So these are the disadvantages. First disadvantages is their state of matter. The state of matter is not explained in a chemical reaction. So some disadvantages I am telling. First disadvantage is the state of matter of any reactant or the product is not mentioned in a chemical equation. That is a disadvantage or a limitation. Then next, the time taken to complete the reaction is not mentioned. Okay. Then next, whether it is a reversible reaction or irreversible reaction, not mentioned. Okay. Or whether it is an exothermic reaction or endothermic reaction, also not explained. Then is the reaction completed or is the reaction incomplete, not explained. So these all are the limitations. Okay. So what are the limitations of a chemical equation? The chemical equations, in some chemical equations, many of the informations are not conveyed, like with the time required to complete a reaction or the state of matter of the substance. Okay, whether it is an exothermic reaction or endothermic reaction, like these informations are not mentioned in a chemical equation, so that we cannot identify whether the reaction is completed or not completed. Okay, this is the limitations of a chemical equation. So many limitations are given. Any 5 limitations you have to study. Okay, first limitation is a chemical equation does not tell the state of substance, whether it is solid state or liquid state or gaseous state. Okay, second limitation is a chemical equation does not show whether the reaction is exothermic reaction or endothermic reaction. Then third disadvantage is a chemical equation does not tell whether it is completed. Okay. Then fourth disadvantage is a chemical equation does not show the time required to finish the reaction. Okay, the time required to finish the reaction is not mentioned. Okay, then next, it will not show whether the reaction is reversible or irreversible. A chemical equation does not show us whether a reaction is reversible or irreversible. So these are the limitations of a chemical equation. Understand? So I think it is clear to all of you the disadvantages and what are the informations conveyed in a chemical equation. So how you can, so we have to remove this limitation, right? So how you can remove this limitation? We have to show the all these informations. If it is given in an equation, it will be easy for us to identify. For example, I am writing one equation, preparation of ammonia. Okay, this is very important. Preparation of ammonia, this we will study in our coming next chapter. Okay, nitrogen gas plus hydrogen gas gives ammonia, NH3. Okay, ammonia. State of substance is written here, gas. Okay, then catalyst Fe and MO. Okay, then the pressure required is 200 to 900 atmospheric pressure, ATM. So these are the information. So now looking at this equation, you can say, no, the reactants, all the reactants and the product state of matter is gaseous state, and the reaction will only take place at 200 to 900 atmospheric pressure, and it require the presence of some catalyst, iron and molybdenum. Okay, so on looking this equation, you can say the reaction will complete at 900 atmospheric pressure. The reaction will completely get completed, and the product and the reactants, everything are in gaseous state. state of matter is explained here, and the catalyst used here, Fe plus MO, is the catalyst used here, and it is an only one side, one headed arrow is there, that is it is an irreversible reaction. So every informations are conveyed here. So if we give all these matters substances, then we can say that a reaction is given with a chemical equation is containing full informations. So for giving, if to remove the all limitations, for removing the all disadvantages, if we will provide all the informations, then we can show that a reaction is became a informative, full additional informations we have to give in an equation. Okay, another equation, see, same last example I have shown, carbon plus oxygen gives carbon dioxide, right? So if I am writing here arrow, that means if carbon burns with oxygen, it will produce carbon dioxide plus heat energy, that means it is an exothermic reaction. Okay, then only one headed arrow is there, so we can say it is an irreversible reaction. So when we will heat only, this reaction will take place. So every informations are given. So this is the, this shows that we can give all the information in a chemical equation and make it as informative. Clear? So this much only our information. And in your page number 15, exercise 1B, question number 5. Okay, question number 5, that is balance the following equations. Balance. Balance the equation. A, B, C, D up to S, that much questions are there. This is your project work. Okay, that is your project. All of you should balance that equation by hit and trial method in your notebook itself. No need of file or anything. In your chemistry, take a new notebook, write this, so complete that one. That is your project work. No need to submit in any file. If you are submitting in any file, I will ask you to rewrite it in notebook. I will not check it in file because I don't want any file work. I have to see it in your notebook. That is your project, holiday homework. Okay, I will add this one in your lofty also. Okay, then next we are going to study relative atomic mass and relative molecular mass. Okay, so before going to this definition, before going to the definition, I am going to teach you some mathematical calculations. Okay, how to calculate a substance. Okay, relative atomic mass, relative atomic mass, that means, see, in our in chemistry, okay, in chemistry a substance is measured with carbon, the mass of carbon. Okay, that is, at the earlier time scientists, they don't know how to measure the mass of an atom. See, for human beings or the heavier things, we can measure by kilogram, unit is kilogram, gram, like that we can measure. But atoms all are very very minute things, so we cannot measure their mass using the units like a kilogram or gram or anything, and we cannot use any things to measure also. So in the case of atoms, a basic unit thing for measuring the substance is mass of carbon. So the mass of carbon you have to by heart is, it is carbon mass is 12 U. U means a unit, one unit, like a gram, kilogram, etc. Okay, 12. So what is relative atomic mass? Okay, atomic mass means a mass of an atom. So how it is related, relative atomic mass? Relative atomic mass means the mass of a carbon atom. Okay, sorry, the mass of an atom. If the question is, find the relative atomic mass of hydrogen. Find the relative atomic mass of hydrogen. So what is relative atomic mass? Relative atomic mass means mass of that atom. Mass of an atom. An atom divided by mass of the atom divided by 1 by 12 mass of one carbon atom. Okay, this is called relative atomic mass. This definition you have to write with this equation. Okay, page number 15 in one box it is mentioned. This definition is enough. What is relative molecular relative atomic mass? It is defined as the ratio of mass of that particular atom. Okay, if it is hydrogen, means the mass of hydrogen divided by 1/12th mass of one carbon atom. Okay, mass of an atom divided by 1/12th mass of one carbon atom is called relative atomic mass. What is relative atomic mass? Relative atomic mass is defined as the ratio of mass of an atom divided by 1/12th the mass of one carbon 12 atom. Understand? Mass of an atom divided by 1/12th the mass of one carbon 12 atom is called relative atomic mass. So here I am writing, find the mass of hydrogen. You know that mass of hydrogen is 1. Okay, so now you are going to find the mass of hydrogen. So simply how you will check is, it is given as the ratio of mass of hydrogen 1, mass of hydrogen is 1, divided by 1/12 into mass of 1 carbon. What is the mass of carbon? 12. So cancelling 12, so what we will get? 1 itself. Simply we are doing like this. Some definition we have to give. For that we will give the definition like this way: mass of that atom divided by 1/12 mass of that carbon 12 atom. Okay, so another, so this much only, this is called relative atomic mass. Okay, so atomic mass unit, so this much only relative atomic mass. So many other definitions are given, don't want to study that all things. Okay, what is relative atomic mass? Relative atomic mass is defined as the ratio of mass of an element or mass of an atom divided by 1/12 into mass of one carbon atom. Okay, then next one is relative molecular mass. What is relative molecular mass? Okay, so relative molecular mass means it is the total mass. See, for example, what is the relative molecule means one full molecule like HCl. What is the relative molecular mass of HCl? Okay, what is relative molecular? Relative molecular mass means relative molecular mass. Relative molecular mass is also known as simple molecular mass. Okay, molecular mass. Simply molecular mass. What is molecular mass or relative molecule? Relative molecular mass means total mass of a molecule. For example, what is the relative molecular mass of HCl? Okay, that means how many hydrogen are there? One hydrogen. Mass of hydrogen plus mass of chlorine is called total mass of HCl. That is called relative molecular mass. Okay, relative molecular mass means the total mass of hydrogen atom plus total mass of chlorine atom present in HCl is called relative molecular mass. Okay, so two definitions we have studied: relative atomic mass and relative molecular mass. Relative atomic mass means it is the ratio of mass of, it is the ratio of mass, ratio of mass of an atom divided by total mass of a, divided by 1/12 of carbon 12 atom is called relative atomic mass. It is represented by the unit U. Okay, relative atomic mass is equal to U. Okay, then what is relative molecular mass? What is relative molecular mass? Relative molecular mass means the total mass of a molecule is called relative molecular mass. Okay, so now we are going to study one topic, one numerical. Find the molecular mass. Do it in your notebook. Okay, molecular mass of H2O, relative molecular mass of H2O. So in this, along with this, it is given in your notebook. Find the relative molecular mass of H2O. So along with this, in the question itself, it will be given mass of hydrogen. Mass of hydrogen equal to 1 and mass of oxygen equal to O is equal to 16. It will be given in the question exam itself. Don't want to by heart their mass. Okay, no need of by hearting atomic mass of any substance. It will be given directly. So what is the relative molecular mass of H2O? So how you will tell? Relative molecular mass is the total mass. So here how many hydrogens are there? 2 hydrogens. So 2 into, we will do multiplication. Total mass means addition only. But when we will here like this numbers, if any H2SO4, these numbers, you know, these numbers 2, for that all we will multiply with that element. Remaining all we will do addition. Okay, multiplication we will do only for these numbers, and remaining all after each, after hydrogen 1 plus we will put, after a sulfur we will put 1s, after oxygen we will put like that, after 1 element we will put plus addition, because we are doing total. And for these numbers we will do multiplication. So here hydrogen for 1, hydrogen 1, number 2 is there. So 2 into multiplication, 2 into hydrogen, mass of hydrogen. Then after that hydrogen 1 plus we will put. Then how many oxygen are there? 1 oxygen. So 1 into oxygen. So 2 into, what is the mass of hydrogen? Mass of hydrogen is 1. Plus 1 into, what is the mass of oxygen? 16. So when we will do the totaling, what you will get? When we will do the totaling, 2 plus 16 is equal to 18 U. This is called the, this is the relative molecular mass of H2O. Understand how you will find the relative molecular mass? One more example I am writing. Find the relative molecular mass of which one? Find the relative molecular mass of NaCl. Okay, NaCl. Okay, no, with some number I will write H2SO4 itself. I am writing H2SO4. Find the relative molecular mass of H2SO4. How you will find the relative molecular mass? For that we have to write the formula first. Relative molecular mass, or the molecular mass, relative molecular mass is equal to, these numbers we have to multiply. So 2 into, how, what is that? 2 is multiplied with the H. 2 into hydrogen. Then after each element we will do addition. Plus, how many sulfur are there? 1 sulfur. So 1 into sulfur is sulfur, S only. Plus, how many oxygens are there? 4 oxygen. So 4 into oxygen. Okay, that number we have to always multiply. Then next 2 into, given in the question it will be given mass of hydrogen. Okay, in the question itself it will be given mass of hydrogen, mass of hydrogen equal to 1. Mass of sulfur will be given in the question itself. It is not given. Mass of sulfur is equal to 32. Okay, then mass of oxygen is equal to 16. This will be given in the question directly. No need to by heart. So when we will substitute that values, how it will come? 2 into hydrogen. What is the value of hydrogen? 1. Plus sulfur 32. Plus 4 into oxygen. Okay. So like this way, we will, then we can do 2 plus oxygen, it is 16. Okay. 4 into 16. 2 plus 32 plus 64. So after we will do the totaling, we will get the final value. So this is the relative molecular mass. Very simple topic it is. Relative atomic mass and relative molecular mass. What is relative atomic mass? Relative atomic mass means what is relative atomic mass? Relative atomic mass means the mass of an element. Mass of an element divided by 1 by 12th mass of one carbon atom. Okay. So this is called relative atomic mass. Relative atomic mass is defined as the ratio of mass of an element to 1 by 12th mass of one carbon atom. Okay, this is called relative atomic mass. It is, okay, then the unit of relative atomic mass is U, symbol U, or AMU, atomic mass unit. Then we have studied next topic, that is relative molecular mass. What is relative molecular mass? Relative molecular mass means the total mass of a molecule. Relative molecular mass is defined as the total mass of a, some another definition is given, this definition is enough. Okay, total mass of a molecule is called relative molecular mass. Okay, or that sum of all the atoms present in a molecule is called relative molecular mass. Okay, then in today's topic, what all things we have studied, what all are the points that we have studied in today's topic? First one is what all are the informations in a chemical equation. In a chemical equation, what all are the informations a chemical equations will carry? What all are the informations that a chemical equations will carry? The number of molecules in a chemical equation, number of molecules present in an both reactants and atoms. And next, what will be the, on looking on a chemical equation, you can say then reactants and products, what will be the reactant and what will be the products taking part, right? So that we can say. Then next, the total mass of a substance. Now you have seen how the mass is calculated, right? So on looking in a chemical equation, like H2 plus Cl2 gives 2HCl. So on looking in this equation, you can see mass of hydrogen plus mass of chlorine is equal to total mass of HCl. So total mass of the substance we can identify using a chemical equation. Then what will be the chemical composition? How many molecules have take part in a chemical equation? That all are the informations. Then next we have studied, after that we have studied what is the informations, what is the limitations. Second we have studied limitations of a chemical equation. What are the limitations? A chemical equation does not show the time taken to complete a chemical equation. Next, a chemical equation does not show whether it is exothermic reaction or endothermic reaction. Then a chemical equation does not show whether the reaction is completed. Then next, a chemical equation does not show the state of matter of the reactant and product, whether it is solid state, liquid state or gaseous state. Then next, a chemical equation does not show whether it is reversible reaction or irreversible reaction. So that are the limitations. Then after that, how you can make a chemical equation informative? How you can show? By showing the state of matter, by writing bracket liquid or gaseous or solid along with that. Okay, then next, if any catalyst are present, that we will write above the arrow. If it is reversible or irreversible, we will show. If it is reversible means we will show double headed arrow. If it is irreversible means a single headed arrow. Okay, like this way. Or if what will be the at which temperature it will react, or what is the pressure required, or whether it is exothermic. If it is exothermic means we will write plus heat at the last. If it is endothermic means we will put a triangle symbol at the above the arrow mark. So these all are the informations. Okay, we can make the chemical equation informative. So then we have studied relative atomic mass, relative molecular mass and one numerical. Okay, that much all of you read your textbook, and that exercise 1B question number 5 started to solve it in your notebook as your project work. Okay, in your notebook itself. I will add these questions in Lofty today itself. Okay, so thank you all of you. Take care.